begin our celebration by calling upon God as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
In the grace and peace of God, our Father, and Lord Jesus Christ, be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pause for a moment and consider how we stand before God and one another. You accepted him contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on our face to the people of the world. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. We are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. You alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that all we ponder in spiritual things, we may carry out in both word and deed that which is pleasing to you. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
In those days, Saul went down to the desert of Ziph, and 3,000 picked men of Israel searched for David in the desert of Ziph. So David and Abishai went among Saul's soldiers by night and found Saul lying asleep within the barricade, with his spear thrust into the ground at his head, and Abner and his men sleeping around him. Abishai whispered to David, "God has delivered your enemy into your grasp this day. Let me nail him to the ground with one thrust of the spear. I will not need a second thrust." But David said to Abishai, "Do not harm him. For who can lay hands on the Lord's anointed and remain unpunished?" So David took the spear and the water jug from their place at Saul's head, and they got away without anyone seeing or knowing or awakening. All remained asleep, because the Lord had put them into a deep slumber. Going across to an opposite slope, David stood on a remote hilltop at a great distance from Abner, son of Ner, and the troops. He said, "Here is the king's spear. Let an attendant come over to get it. The Lord will reward each man for his justice and faithfulness. Today, though the Lord delivered you into my grasp, I would not harm the Lord's anointed." The word of the Lord. The Lord is kind and merciful.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all my being. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not his benefits.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
He pardons all your iniquities, heals all your ills. He redeems your life from destruction, crowns you with kindness and compassion.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
Merciful and gracious is the Lord, slow to anger and abounding in kindness. Not according to our sins does he deal with us, nor does he requite us according to our crimes.
The Lord is kind and merciful.
As far as the east is from the west, so far has he put our transgressions from us. As a father has compassion on his children, so the Lord has compassion on those who fear him. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, it is written, the first man, Adam, became a living being. The last Adam, a life-giving spirit. But the spiritual is not the first, rather the natural, then the spiritual. The first man was from the earth, earthly. The second man, from heaven. As was the earthly one, so also are the earthly. And as is the heavenly one, so also are the heavenly. Just as we have borne the image of the earthly one, we shall also bear the image of the heavenly one. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Jesus said to his disciples, to you who hear, I say, love your enemies. Do good to those who hate you. Bless those who curse you and pray for those who mistreat you. To the person who strikes you on one cheek, offer the other one as well. And from the person who takes your cloak, do not withhold even your tunic. Give to everyone who asks of you, and from the one who takes what is yours, do not demand it back. Do to others as you would have them do to you. For if you love those who love you, what credit is there for that? Even sinners love those who love them. And if you do good to those who do good to you, what credit is that to you? Even sinners do the same. If you lend money to those whom you expect repayment, what credit is that to you? Even sinners do that and get the same amount. Rather, I say love your enemies and do good to them, and lend expecting nothing back. Then your reward will be great, and you will be children of the Most High. For he himself is kind to the ungrateful and to the wicked. Be merciful, just as your Father in heaven is merciful. Stop judging and you will not be judged. Stop condemning and you will not be condemned. Forgive and you will be forgiven. Give and gifts will be given to you. A good measure packed together, shaken down and overflowing will be poured into your lap. And the measure with which you measure will in turn be measured out to you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Reading newspapers these days, listening to the radio, watching television, watching the internet, can be depressing, even frightening sometimes. The levels of violence are incredible, within families, within communities, within and between states, between and among cultures, and of course, within ourselves. But this is not a new phenomenon. After all, Cain killed Abel, and it seems like it's been downhill ever since. The bad news is that violence will probably continue to some degree for a very long time. The sort of good news is that it really doesn't have to continue, at least not to the degree that we experience it now. Because violence is a matter of choice. A choice that one person or many people make. Sometimes it's made through frustration, sometimes out of desperation, sometimes out of fear, but mostly it's a choice. mostly a bad choice and an unnecessary choice, notwithstanding times of self-defense and the defense of others. Violence is wrong. And this is not from a perspective of someone who hasn't lived and dealt with various forms of violence in his lifetime. And I'm talking about St. Francis de Sales. During his episcopacy, the conflict between Catholics and Protestants was a violent one. It was out of control, and it was dehumanizing. It was on both sides, fighting, interesting and ironically, in the name of a loving God. Francis preached against the violence. While he opposed the actions of the Calvinists and wished to eliminate their teaching in his diocese, he saw this as a pastoral problem that should be solved through preaching, through teaching, through persuasion and goodwill, not through the blunt force of violence. He wrote in one of his letters, "Let us exchange bad will for goodwill, bad courage for good courage. If we have charity among us, we will have peace." During his years in the Chablais, through his preaching, through his teaching and his charity among all the people who were there, and this was during a terrible time of violence and destruction, Francis de Sales was responsible for literally thousands of converts to our faith, through his charity, through his gentleness, through his humility. But Francis was very understanding of the human condition. He understood our tendency to react to situations, to do things contrary, even to his own teaching and preaching of gentleness and peace. He was very aware of his own personal shortcomings, his own weaknesses, and his own deficiencies. Following a sermon one day on today's gospel reading, talking about turning the other cheek, someone approached him outside the cathedral and said, and the attitude of the person was the same kind of attitude the Pharisees approached Jesus. "Well, Father de Sales," the person said, "that was truly an inspiring, arousing, and even a motivating sermon. But what if I were to strike you on your right cheek? Would you turn and offer me your left cheek?" And without missing a beat, Father de Sales smiled and responded, "I know what I should do, but I don't know what I would do." The man walked away with no further comment. We all face conflict. Sometimes that conflict can lead to destructive, aggressive, and alienating behaviors. But we all know it doesn't have to lead to such behaviors. They are choices, and not very good choices. So what do we do? There is the Christian response. There is the Salesian response. There is the healthy response. Step back and examine where conflict exists in your life. Identify it. And then follow the teachings of Francis de Sales, who writes, "Listen with an open mind. Listen with the ears of faith. Listen. And then speak cor ad cor. Speak heart to heart with the person with whom you have conflict. And see the goodness in others. Seek peace through collaboration. Seek peace through understanding." And Francis ends by saying, "Thereby you will build the kingdom of Christ established and invited each of us to continue in his holy name." May God be blessed, and may God bless each of you as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
having heard God's word and having reflected upon what that word means in their lives. Let us profess. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial of the Father. Through him all things are made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and amen. For our sake, he was crucified and punished by it. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
We pause now as we place our petitions before the throne of God.
For all of our church leaders, especially Pope Francis, Bishop Verbridge, and our parish priests, they will preach the gospel with courage and conviction. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our nation, that together we will promote the common good of all, safeguard the sanctity of marriage and the family, and defend the rights to life and to religious freedom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For justice, security, and peace among nations, especially between Russia and Ukraine, and China and Taiwan, and for those who serve in our law enforcement, military, intelligence, and diplomatic services to make peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Christians who face persecution and genocide, especially in communist and Islamic countries, that the Holy Spirit will keep them strong in the faith, and for all non-believers, that the Holy Spirit will move them to faith in our divine Savior. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the safety of the construction workers and the success of our building project, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our children and teachers in school, especially at St. Agnes, that they will be safe from all harm and strive to do their best, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the acceptance of vocations to the priesthood and religious life, that young men and women from our own families will keep Christ's call and offer their lives to him who gave his life for us. And for our parish seminarians, Tony Bennett, Mike Nugent, James Joseph, Gabriel Gaudet, and for Anne Whalen and Caroline Jones, postulants with the Nashville Dominicans, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and homebound, and for our deceased, especially Helena Metzger and John and Kathleen Long, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for John and Amal Anthony, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own personal intentions, which we offer in the quiet of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty Father, we come before you this morning with our prayers and petitions. We ask you to hear the petitions which we have spoken aloud, and all the prayers and petitions each of us holds in our hearts. We place them before you in the name of Christ Jesus, your Son. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through your goodness we have this great offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Bless God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty God.
The Lord is such a sacrifice and for our good and for all the church.
As we celebrate your mysteries, O Lord, with the observance that is your due, we humbly invite you and ask you that what we offer to the honor of your majesty may profit us for salvation. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer, who lived like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy. Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, of the Son and of the Christ. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, of the Son and of the Christ.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like to do for us, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." Supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks to you who have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, St. Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait for blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom and power and glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am my good and just as I am my good. But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Amen.
Yeah.
to our brothers and sisters who are not able to be here with us today. Read to them from Holy Scripture, offer them the body and blood of Christ, and give them my love and regards. And may you go in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. There are several announcements this morning. Our full box collection this weekend is for the four players. As we know, they're a group of cloistered sisters in Alexandria, and they depend on others for their livelihood. All teams are invited to a youth group Tuesday at 7:30 for adoration with the opportunity for confessions, and at 6:30 before youth group, work camp meeting will take place. All are invited to the Lenten retreat with St. Mary Magdalene on Saturday, March 5th in Parish Hall. Please see the bulletin for details. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we may experience the effects of salvation which is pledged to us by these mysteries. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.